It's Neil Atkinson and it's Adam Melia doing a preview. We're going to try and do it outside, but Liverpool's weather is currently, I'd say, wildly unpredictable. So the rain has actually gone off, but there's a lot of moisture on the ground, it's fair to say. So the idea of us trying to find a little thing to sit on something like that just didn't appeal.
Rain at times, yeah. Moderate or good?
Yeah, very much so. Probably the whole day.
Rain at times, poor.
That one's
if
not a bad
one. If I was
doing
shipping forecast.
Yeah, that one's not a bad one either. But no, today was really sunny before, but it's just got a bit moody. So we've come inside to talk about two things. One is Liverpool versus Norwich, or more accurate, Norwich versus Liverpool. The other one is that it falls on your birthday.
Oh, yeah.
You are the king of the opening day birthday, really. Almost every opening weekend is your birthday weekend.
Well, I mean, the opening weekend tends to fall around the, around the 14th. And there's a few of us. Mm. Kev Walsh is, I think, the 12th. Famous Mick Clark of tickets is the 12th as well. So there's a few opening weekend red birthdays. I'm happy to be part of that gang.
It's a good gang to be part of. I think it's...
It makes deciding what to do on your birthday as a 39-year-old easy, at least.
Very easy, yeah. definitely go and get that one sorted out. There is, for me, with this one, I'm sort of pleased with the second game at home. In that, if it was the first game back in front of fans and it was at Anfield, it would have almost, and it was your birthday, it would have almost all felt just far too enormous in a really weird way. Like, I'm enjoying the build here where game one away will be full of raucous East Anglians, game and 3,000 Liverpool supporters. Game two, home, Burnley, 12:30. So it's not a massive game, but it's a huge occasion.
It's a massive event. Yeah.
And then European Champions half five bank holiday weekend. I feel as though it's lovely scripting this in order to get us where we need to be emotionally.
Yeah, no, you're right. I think this one in particular, I like the newly promoted team away aspect of it as well. I think that it reminds me a little bit of Watford when Salah's first game was that Watford away did end 3-3. But yeah, so it felt like for years we were always away first, and it was, in fact, it was something that became a mild yearly kickoff among Liverpool fans, and then and then we sort of managed to fix it. I don't know what it was. Maybe it was Ferguson retiring, but we fixed it, and we've been quite regularly at home of late. But I quite like the away. Aspect. I like, in a way, in the summer at 5 p.m. It's lovely, and so yeah, I don't know. It makes you go all Ron Manager, and I was playing it down, but it fills my soul with romance, the idea of it all. So it is extremely exciting, and I think, as you say, I love the step up into the first home game against Burnley, which, you know, if that was on December the 1st or something,
or a normal season where we haven't just had all this,
you wouldn't feel any romance, really. It'd be grim reality of it, but I think that everyone will again be swept up by the romance of it being the first home game back. And you know, it's, as you say, early kickoff. In fact, well, who knows what time it'll kick off with the energy?
2:45.
Yeah, and then the Chelsea game, which to be honest, I thought was away until the other day. So I'm glad I hadn't planned to be away.
Lovely surprise. But
yeah, it's gonna be brilliant. The whole thing, coming off the back of the two games in 2 days, which, yep, who knew that was going to be so exciting?
Yep.
I mean, I would have said that was a bad idea, but actually it was a good idea. I loved watching Liverpool twice in 2 days, just before the big kickoff. It felt like a real ramping up, and you know, made everybody feel like we've got a great crack at this. Good squad, two good teams there that we can put out. So yeah, everything's looking good to me.
The great crack of this is the part for me that I'm sort of grasped across the last sort of 4 weeks or so. This is about a reclamation of what there was before the injuries to the centre-halves, a reclamation of what there was in terms of what we lost, being able to have the party towards winning the league. The big difference, I think you can draw a line in 1920, and it is, rightly or wrongly, I would say wrongly, it should have been earlier, but it is United at home. where everyone then was able to get behind the fact that this is all but done and you're meant to enjoy it. Mm. Before then, there was the idea, even when they were winning every single week, this is all about to go badly wrong and it's going to hurt us like we've never been hurt before in our lives. For some people, and the line is in different places. For me, I almost feel you can go as far back as Leicester at home when they make it 8 out of 8, at which point for me, they just become favourites that day. But my point being is that it still felt like fraught with, we've been so close so many times, this isn't going to happen. Yeah. The point now is that we didn't get to have the party. We didn't get to be league champions. We didn't get to swank around the country, giving it the big one in various away grounds. But what we did get to be was champions. Yeah. I'm hopeful that maybe, just maybe, if we can do the same again, not quite exactly the same, but we do the same again, we can enjoy it a bit more throughout off the basis of, well, we've won one, we've all got one now. Me and you, we've both seen them win it.
All right, the Reds, thanks for watching a little bit of a premium Anfield Wrap video there. If you want to watch the rest of that show and get access to much, much more, click join below. That activates our YouTube membership. It means you get a premium video every day of the week. You get our post-match content. You get reviews, previews, and exclusive interviews all here from the heart of Liverpool. Follow us, follow them. Up the Reds.